finally, the bill has been passed. And I want to congratulate the workers and my colleagues as well.
Today, Parliament straight away started from where they ended yesterday at committee stage to scrutinize the NSSF Amendment Bill 2021 clause by clause. The House amended Clause 7 of the Bill 2021 to tighten penalties for non-compliance, providing that employers who deduct voluntary contribution and fail to remit to the NSSF commit an offence and fined by 20% of the money deducted and not remitted. This replaces the earlier proposal in the bill of forcing the employer to pay 20 million fine or face 3 years in prison.
The committee proposed a fine not exceeding 1,000 currency points or imprisonment not exceeding 3 years or both. We are proposing that the same be amended to read that a person who fails to remit shall pay a fine of 20% of the amount deducted but not remitted.
Courts in that clause 7 as amended stand part of this bill, vote in favor, say aye to the contrary, no. There is have it. Thank you.
MPs also approved clause 12 to allow a member who contributes to the fund for 10 years and aged 45 years and above to be allowed mid-term access to their benefits accrued from savings.
The most interesting section of the bill is about people who have saved honestly with NSSF for 10 years can now access their money. Even those who are above 45 years, they can also now access their money. But there is also provision for either the disabled or poor critically sick.
The whole country should celebrate for those that have been badly hit by the COVID pandemic, as we are well aware. That is why this bill had to come, to make provisions for those who have been contributing to the fund to be able at least to access some of their money.
The law has also cleared members with disability who clock 40 years and have made contributions for at least 10 years to access up to 50% of their accrued benefits.
Persons with disabilities, we are the biggest winners in this bill. Because the 10th Parliament had proposed that they were proposing that we take 75% of our savings as mid-term, but the President, in his wisdom, said that 75% was high and therefore we would exhaust our savings. So we reconsidered his view and we requested for 50%.
We have already agreed with the President that this is the bill. Who is supposed to play which role and which role? That is Minister of Gender, Labour and Social Development. And then the Minister of Finance, the role they are going to play. So for us as workers, we now expect His Excellency the President to sign this bill. At the same time, I've discussed with the Minister of Labour, who is responsible to expedite the regulation.
Although MPs had rejected the proposal to house NSSF under supervision of the Minister of Finance, today they struck a compromise and accepted dual supervision by handing over some functions to do with investments and finances to the Minister of Finance, but having the Minister of Gender as overall supervisor. MPs detected that the President may reject the bill again if his interests are not catered for.
I am expressing fears because we know how NSSF has been running. The fear is that the minister, you can imagine, these amendments are 10, this whole list. Everywhere there is minister, she says, now we move, put finance. So for you, what are you going to supervise? If everything is you are sending it to finance, what are you going to supervise? Is it the buildings or the vehicles?
The first function in this act is to mobilize workers to contribute. When they contribute, yes, through our labor officers, through the government structure, through others, the workers' organizations, registration of workers' organization is done in the Ministry of Labor, and they contribute.
The general position of the House was that this bill and the general supervision of the Act should be under the ministry responsible for the workers, that is Ministry of Gender, Labour and Social Development. But you are aware that this provision was rejected by the President, it was returned to the House, and under our rules, if the President writes, the House can consider and accept the proposal by the President, or we can hold our position.
It was huge celebrations as the yes had it all in favor of the bill to clear the second bill of the 11th Parliament.
The bill entitled the National Social Security Amendment Bill 2021 be read for the third time and do pass. I put the question to that motion. Those in favor to the contrary, no. The ayes have it.
A bill for an act entitled the National Social Security Fund Amendment Act 2021.
Congratulations, Honorable Minister. Congratulations, Chair. And thank you, members. Congratulations.
Story by Fred Kajubi for the news.